Let's first understand the application. This is the book info application. This is the sample application that comes along with the Istio distribution. Now there are four microservices. You have the product microservice, you have the reviews, then you have the ratings, and then you have the details. Now these microservices have been implemented in different programming languages, and a reviews microservice is a bit special microservice because you do have three different versions of this particular microservice. So you have the reviews v1, then version v2, and then finally version v3. Now in v1 you don't have the star that actually represent the reviews. So v1 is without any star, v2 is with the black star, and v3 is with the red star. Now as I talked earlier, you have the envoy proxy that gets injected as a sidecar, or let's say a super lightweight sidecar, and that is being represented over here in the brown color. So all of these entities are nothing but the envoy proxies, and now you can see that you do have the envoy proxy along with each of your pod, inside your pod, and that's how your request get intercepted. And now you can actually connect the dots as how the rate limiting or the circuit breaker or your routing, all of this different sort of things are happening. So the envoy communicates with the mixer, which is in your control plane of the Istio, and that's how it comes to know about the different instances of the pods of your microservices, then the health check, and then the load balancing. And then in front of everything you have the ingress envoy, or the ingress, which is the API gateway, and this actually acts as the front side to your entire application. And then you can have the ingress, which actually controls your outgoing traffic. It's not there as a part of this demo. Now I've already installed EKS cluster. It's a 3-node large instance cluster, and I've already enabled or installed the service mesh, which is Istio as a part of the demo. And if I go to the kubectl get all, then you will see that this all of the workload or the deployments are rolled out. Then you have the replica set and the different stuff. Now Istio resides in the different namespace. So you have the get all from the Istio system, and all of the different components of Istio, actually they are deployed as a part of the pod or the services or horizontal pod scaler in case of HP or the job. So everything as a part of the deployment either gets the service or pod or some other kind of the Kubernetes, and that's how this entire mechanism works inside the Kubernetes. So even if your Istio, one of the pod, goes down, because of the desired state guarantee, automatically the new pod is spun up, and you don't have to worry about your Istio, which is kind of managing, monitoring for the telemetry, for the routing, for the rate limiting, and so on. So you can see that you have the different Istio components, such as Citadel, egress gateway, pilot, ingress gateway, sidecar injector, and so on. Along with that, you do have the Prometheus and Kiali, which we will see in a bit. And if I just want to open the application, then this is the application. So you have the EKS endpoint, and then you have the product page. Now as I discussed earlier, as a part of this reviews, you have V1, V2, V3. Now by default I already created the rule in the policy, in the trafficking policy, such that all of these three versions actually get automatically load balanced. So when I hit the request, then you can see that in my book reviews, either the V1 is actually there as of now, then next time it is V3, the red star, then you have the black star which indicates it's V2. So you can do this many times and then you can see that automatically the services or the requests are getting load balanced. Now as a part of the routing policy, what I want to do is I want to ensure that my V2, V3, only these two versions are there, and then I want to control the traffic. So this could be a different instances of your same microservice, or this could be your different versions, or this could be your different clusters of your two different microservices. So this could be anything. So routing can be used in different scenarios. Before we jump onto this, I just want to highlight the fact that we have just created the images, we have not done anything in the code, and we have just created the workload deployment with the replica set and so on, which is a very normal Kubernetes thing. So over here you will not find anything related to the Istio. We are not doing anything in the code, in the configuration. We are not even touching the code or configuration. For the gateway, what we have done is we have added the book info gateway. I have already done that. It's a kind of virtual service. So kind is virtual service. So you have the destination rule, which is another kind which comes along with the Istio. And then you can see that the different URIs getting consolidated into one domain, and the API gateway now acting as the load balancer, as the traffic router controller, and it is playing different roles in our ecosystem. And now coming back to our traffic routing policy, what I want to do is, now we have V1, V2, V3. Now I want to have only V2 and V3, and then I just want to specify the weighing factor, which is 50-50. So 50% of the request will go to V2, 50% of the request will go to V3. And note that over here everything depends on your service name, which is in this case review. So you need to have this consideration in place. Automatically, whenever you have the specification over there, you need to just provide the host, and that's it. Automatically the request start routing to different versions. So let's apply this particular configuration. So let me just go into the samples and book info networking, and let's say kubectl apply f, and you have the virtual service for the reviews. And like any other kind, this gets applied. Now if I go back to my application, remember we had V1, which is no star. Now if I play the request, now you will see that either I have V2 or V3. V1 is out of the equation now, because of the traffic routing policy that specifies that the traffic should go to V2 or V3. So now this has been done on the fly without touching your pod, existing pod, right, or existing code or configuration. Now other thing which is very common nowadays is the A/B testing. So as a part of that, or the canary deployment, as a part of that, in the production you want to have two different clusters, there is a logical partition, you want to test a few of the features. It could be your front end, it could be the new feature that you have just launched. So you want to do it separately for few set of customers or users, and there comes the HTTP header match. Now this feature is used to have the routing different for the different users. So as a part of this, you can see that I do have the similar host, the same host, which is reviews, and now there is a HTTP matching that is happening on the header, and now there is a support in my reviews microservice that it adds the end user in your HTTP header. Now Istio intercepts the request, figures out the who is the user, and based on that, if the user is JSON, I can add my name in that as well. So if user is Nikhil, then just route the traffic to V2, otherwise route the traffic to V3. So let me just say V1. So for any other user, traffic will be V1. For me, it will be V2. So I don't have to do anything else. I just have to apply the definition, and that's it. So it is the virtual service reviews. And you can see that it has been configured, and let me just, okay, so let me sign in with my user, and now you can see that I always get V2, which is actually represented by the black star. So I always get the V2 because of the fact that all of the requests are coming from Nikhil, that is me. And if I sign out and log in with any other user, let's say admin. Now, as a part of this, you will see that admin or any other user always gets the V1, which is no star. So that's how you can do the A/B testing or canary deployment or such sort of things with ease without modifying anything in your deployment topology, configuration, or application code. So now you can understand what's happening behind the scene. This is just a trailer. In the full picture, you can use a rate limiter, you can use circuit breaker, you can make use of the telemetry, which is absolutely fantastic in Istio. You have the distributed tracing, and you also have the service graph, and so on. So many things can be done with Istio. So in order to have the service graph, you have Kiali, which is the service observability tool that comes along with the Istio. So if you go to the graph, then you can see that what is happening. So based on the invocation, how the calls are going, how the APIs are communicating with each other, what is my request per second, how the traffic is going on. Now Grafana is much more superior to Kiali in this regard, but over here the main thing to look is the Istio config. In the Istio config, you can see that for the reviews, you have this kind of virtual services, and what are the rules, and you can also see the YAML associated with the with this. So this is Kiali, which is used for the service observability. Now you have the Grafana, and now there is a Prometheus. I will not go into this, but finally Grafana comes really handy, right? So you have Grafana, in which you can see the performance of your microservices, the different resource details, memory, CPU, and so on. And then at the same time, you can also understand the health of your Kubernetes cluster. Now, depending upon the namespace, you can go to the different dashboard, and then you can do different things. So I'm interested in the Istio mesh that will give me the performance of my microservices. So you can see that for the product page, we have so many requests. If I have the box plot, then the percentile 50, 90, 99, latency, what is the success rate. If I go a bit deeper, then you will see that from the source, from how many requests are coming to the destination. You can filter the data based on this, based on the inbound workload and outbound services. So it gives you very precious, very useful dashboard for your microservices and obviously for your Kubernetes cluster. And that is happening without any hassle. It's very easy to do with the help of Istio. Finally, I want to discuss about the Yager, which is the open tracing over here. So Yager gives you the end-to-end holistic view for any of your traces. So you can get onto your any particular request, and then Yager will actually give you the spans from the starting point or the entry point and the exit point. For example, when we hit the product page, this particular page, we started with the ingress gateway, we got onto the product page, then reviews, and then finally to the rating. So you can see that how these spans are actually petered against each of the microservice API invocation. And this could be a synchronous call or this could be a asynchronous call. And you can actually see how much time has been spent in each of the microservice API invocation. And over here, you get the context ID, and that context ID is used in your logger. And that's why you need to change your application. But once you have this in place, then it is super easy for the developers to get the holistic view, understand what's happening in the system, and get onto the this debugging, and then solve the issue.